Hi you guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Cole named Chanel and I'm back, but clearly I'm back with a story time. Now this story time is gonna be crazy per usual because all my story times are crazy per usual. If you're new here, welcome. If you're a returning subscriber, then you know, like I know, it's all love. I don't know where I'm gonna start with this story time. I swear they're all starting to sound alike because it's a scam. Probably one of the only times y'all get the recent story time. There was somebody in my comments. They had the exact same YouTube name as me, codename Chanel, with my exact picture. They were using that picture to scam my subscribers into sending them a bunch of money, saying that they were gonna mentor them to find a sugar daddy. Keep in mind, if you need help, I have a mentorship where you can schedule a phone call with me, or I have Patreon. Those are two ways you can get to Chanel, okay? You don't need to go through WhatsApp. I don't even really have a WhatsApp. I do have a WhatsApp, but that's why I wanna go get surgery in Colombia and DR. I don't really use WhatsApp for nothing else. The person was in the comments with my exact same name. Only thing they didn't have was the verified check mark. They were responding to comments saying, hey, you know, contact me on WhatsApp, dear. I can help you. And you know, they were misspelling words and whatever. So people were actually falling for it and sending 300, 400, 500, 600, thousands of dollars to this person that's in my comments. And I, at the time, like I was just furious. I was highly upset because first off, I don't like seeing my subscribers get scammed. That's one thing I don't like. And I don't want nobody to feel like I would do something like that or that it was me, but clearly it's not me. It's somebody like, I think it was a foreigner. I really think it was somebody that wasn't in the United States just from the way their lingo was. Anyway, they're on WhatsApp and they're rude too. They're being codenamed Chanel, but they're giving it to them. They're like, oh, are you going to pay me or not? Dear, I can't give you any finesse game if you don't send the money. No more conversation. Bye, see ya. And then the person would send the money and I'm like, then they would send me screenshots. They're like, oh, I thought it was you. I'm like, I don't care who it is. If they're rude to me, you're not getting my money. So the fact that y'all are still sending this rude codename Chanel, the evil codename Chanel money, that really upset me. So anyway, time goes by. People are kind of picking up that it's a scam. Yes, I did send some people their money back, even though it was not me. I don't do that anymore. So don't even try it. I don't do that shit no more because if you don't know a scam, you need to do your due diligence and figure out who's who. Because I don't got $1,000 just to give it out to people. I don't got $300 just to give it out to people. I don't got it. And I've seen Cash Doll do the same thing when someone has stole her identity and pretend to be like her makeup artist or something like that. And once somebody who's a fan of hers wanted to work with Cash Doll and sent the person the money, whatever. Cash Doll didn't end up sending the person the money back, which was really sweet. And you know, but we can't be doing that with 10, 15, 20 people. That doesn't make any sense. I know Cash Doll got way more money than me and she spends like $600. So I'm like, I can't do that six times. I can't. After that kind of cooled down, now I'm really getting into the story, you guys. So after that kind of cooled down, I had went to go get my hair done at this shop that I really ain't never even been to. Like, no, I'd never been to there before. This is the girl's first time doing my hair. And I was getting a wig installed, you know, and I'm just chilling. And keep in mind, like, I'm in a shop. It was a pretty packed shop. So, you know, I'm getting my hair braided down because now it's all washed and stuff and it's blow dried out and I'm getting it braided down. And let's just call this person, let's just say that this girl, Rebecca, it was this random lady. She walked up to me.
As soon as she walked up, I peeped her aura.
Y'all, I'm telling you, this is a recent story time. This is one time I'm giving it to y'all with something that happened to me. It was earlier this year, but nevertheless, she walks up to me and she's like, hey, can I talk to you real quick? And I'm getting my hair braided down. So I'm like, right here, right now, you can talk to me. She's like, no, can we step outside? So I turn to the beautician and the beautician is doing my hair, talks to the lady. She's like, oh, you know, I'm doing her hair right now. So maybe like after I finish, you know, doing the hair. And the girl's like, okay, that's fine. So then when she walks away, like we talk to each other, she's like, do you know her? I'm like, girl, I don't know her. I don't know why she wanna take it outside. She was like, oh, maybe she messing with your dude or maybe you sleeping with her man. I said, I don't have those issues. That can't be it. The girl walks away, my hair gets finished. I look at my hair, I'm like, okay, I'm cute, I like it, or whatever. and it was out of sight, out of mind. I wasn't even worried about her. So I get to my car, and before I'm getting in my car, she confronts me again. She comes to me. She's like, hey, you know, I wanted to talk to you. Like, blah, 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 I want to talk to you. I'm like,
okay.
So what do we need to talk about? Do you know me? She's like, yeah, I do know you. My daughter, she's in college. She sent you $75 and you canceled a hair appointment. So y'all, I started laughing. I started cracking up.
I fucking hate it here. I hate it here.
I'm like, no, you're not talking about me. And she was like, yeah, you. So she pulls up a picture, you guys, of me. Of me. And she responds, so what happened? And I explained to her, I'm like, babe, I don't do hair. Someone is using my picture. This is nothing new. I end up pulling up my YouTube channel. I'm like, girl, this is who I am. I mean, what a coincidence you run into me. And then I'll get to, y'all, I'm telling you, this is why I don't want people fucking using my pictures.
What if it was you?
That's crazy. She's like, I knew something was wrong. And we couldn't find any other pictures but that one picture, because they only have one picture of me. And it's a picture I actually posted on Snapchat and my Instagram story. It's not even a picture on my page. It's like a selfie of me. I'll attach the picture right here. And this is the picture that they have on Facebook. And they have some name. Facebook is Chantel Unique Brown. What type of fake ass name is that? But yeah, that's the name on Facebook, Chantel Unique Brown, using my picture, my adorable picture. I did my own makeup in that picture. That was not professionally done. They stole that picture from me. And so me and the lady, we chopping it up. You know, I'm telling her, I'm like, you know, if I was trying to scam somebody or whatever, I wouldn't be using my own pictures. I was like, I don't even braid hair, nothing. And I know some of you probably be like, oh, you know, I'm not gonna explain myself to people, but like, at this point, I'm thinking it's an isolated incident, and that was it. Like, okay, that happened, this person scammed this person. I was thinking, that's it, you know, me and the lady had chopped it up, and I told her, like, tell your daughter, I'm so sorry. I don't know why someone is using my picture to scam people. That doesn't even make, that doesn't make any sense, but I think it's just somebody who does not like me and just wants me to get, like, jumped or beat up, or somebody think that I'm actually out here stealing people's deposit. When I don't not do hair at all. Can't even do my own hair. Don't know how to do hair. So that incident happens. And this time, out of sight, out of mind again. Like, I'm thinking like, okay, that happened, whatever. I'm cute, I'm about to go out and just enjoy, you know, my life or whatever, right? So I get a call from my makeup artist. I get a FaceTime. And I answer the FaceTime, I'm talking to my makeup artist. My makeup artist like, you know, it's so weird. So one of my other clients came in here and was asking questions about you, asking if you did hair, all these other things. Again, y'all, I didn't put two and two together. My makeup artist was the person that he was talking about. Let's just call her Lily. So Lily started bringing up like, hey, like, do you know if she's, you know, if this is her? And he was like, that's her picture, but she's not scamming people. Because basically Lily was asking if I was scamming people. And she's like, he's like, she's not scamming people. That's not even her. That's crazy. And he told me, he was like, I just set the record straight that you would never do nothing like that. That's clearly somebody using your picture. And then I guess he broke it down to her like, yeah, she's an influencer. She has a YouTube channel. And she tells me people use her pictures all the time. So at this point, Chantel Unique Brown, Dr. Seuss, Willy Wonka person is really messing up my reputation. Like, this is getting weird. Now people are asking my makeup artist if that's me. So, and you guys, it's really upset.
I'm upset, like I get ghetto.
At this point, I was stressed. I was like, I'm going out and like none of my friends could go out with me. I don't even think I hit none of my friends up. Sometimes I do like to ride solo, you guys. I'm not gonna lie to you. Solo by myself, and I'm like, okay, let me go out and get some drinks. So I went out, I got some drinks by myself. And then after I got the drinks, old girl, the one who did the who was asking my makeup artist about me, Lily. Lily hits me up on Instagram and she's like, hey, you know, I'm celebrating my business, like 10 years, let's link up, you know, let's go out together. And I'm like, oh, well, I'm already out. And she was like, cool, pull up to this club or whatever. And we just call the club like Club Plush or whatever. She like, pull up to Club Plush or whatever, like I got you or whatever. So I pull up, the line is super long. I mention their name, I get in or whatever. And really at this point, I'm not even looking for her. Like I'm just chilling by myself. So, cause again, y'all, I'm already out. So I get a FaceTime, like a Instagram FaceTime, because we don't have numbers. And she like, oh, okay, like come to section or whatever. Go party with her. Had a great time, like turned up, partying, living la vida loca. And the next morning, I get a phone call, like from my best friend. My best friend calling me. She's like, look at your phone, look at your phone. So I looked at my phone and I see, and keep in mind, y'all, I don't even have a Facebook. I don't have a Facebook. So I don't know what's going on Facebook unless somebody sends it to me. So my best friend, like, check your phone, and then I see like this post or whatever, and I'm just attached this post here, and it's like, oh, Chantel, wait, let me just read it, you guys, so y'all can see. It says, see, thirsty broke bitches like this is the reason why DFW hair, I think they meant stylist, got such a bad rep. Scammer alert. So there is my picture, you guys. Oh my God, the brown unique Chantel. And there's like 22 messages, and this is in DFW All About Hair Weave. I'm not even in this group. Like, I don't even know nothing about Facebook. Like, the only time that I'm on Facebook is if my sisters are something. I'm like, oh, can y'all look this up for me or whatever, see if y'all can find it on Facebook. Other than that, I'm not on Facebook. So there's 22 messages between it. That Cash App Chantel Unique One, not even my Cash App, but Miss Chantel, like, who is this person? But there's 40 comments, you guys, and now it's probably like 200 comments under that post. And my best friend had commented, she's like, that's not even the person, like, you guys are wrong, and that's not, you know, that's my best friend. And basically the same thing, having to defend me again and explain that it's not me. And then that's when I broke it to my best friend, like, yeah, this, you know, this girl actually approached me about this. And not only that, so the Lily girl, they're using her hair pictures, because she actually has a business. They're using her hair pictures and saying that it's me. So after me and Lily had hung out that night, and my sisters were skeptical about me hanging out with her, but I didn't even think about it like that, because again, you all, like I said, when the girl confront, I'm not scared, I'm not shaking in my boots. You know what I'm saying? Like, if something happened, I'm gonna handle it. If not, then it is what it is. But I'm not about to be running for, this ain't me, I didn't do this shit. It's not me. Somebody's using my identity. So, you guys. Right after that, I'm seeing all these messages. Everybody's saying that this person's a scam. Some people are still believing that it's me. Like, oh, when I see her, I'ma whoop her ass. People in the comments say they're gonna be mine. And my best friend comments, she's like, why would she use her own pictures to scam? Like, I want y'all to really think. If I'm myself out here taking deposits and people in the comments like, oh, she took my deposit too, why would I use my own pictures? And then on top of that, I'm stealing somebody else's pictures, so y'all can really steal in somebody else's work. Like, it's really to the point where the person who's using my identity got Arrogant Tay pictures, did Ari's hair. You really think Chantel Brown, Unique Brown, did Ari's hair? Like, come on now, y'all. Just, and that's what I'm saying, like, the common sense and doing their due diligence. Like, I'm not doing it no more. I'm not defending it. I'm not sending nobody no money back. It's not me. I have a channel. I have a YouTube channel. And if it's not about sugaring, then leave me out of it. Please leave me out of it. Anyway, so Lily hit me up again about the same stuff, because Chantel Unique Brown was still using her pictures. And I was like, you know, there's nothing I can do. This is life. This is, there's literally nothing I can do. And she's like, you know, you should check to see if it's anybody close to you. And here's the thing, even if it's somebody close to me, which is not, because it's not. Let's just be clear, it's not. It's one of my, like, this has never happened before. Stuff like this never happened before I had a channel. All these weird ass story times that I have to tell you guys only happens because I have a YouTube channel. Before I had a YouTube channel, it was peace and quietness. I'm telling you, if y'all see the amount of emails I get, the amount of hate and men. So no. We're not gonna put this on my family and friends. We're gonna put it straight on the weirdos who it is. And I was like, girl, well, they're using your hair pictures. I don't know why they would think to use your hair pictures. They're like, check your circle too, babe. But she was like, oh, I'm just gonna go to police. I said, do the police, make a report. I was like, this has been happening to me all the time. Do what you gotta do. And I'm not sure if she made a police report or not. But you know, the Chantel Unique Brown, I think she changed her name, or she might have blocked my best friend from her page. I'm not sure. You guys can look it up on Facebook. See if she's still around. Let me know. So after that, that's kind of how that situation ended. I don't know if she's still using my identity to scam people, but beware, it's not me. I don't do hair. I don't ask you guys to message me on WhatsApp and send me $1,000. Like, I just don't. I have Patreon for that. Join my Patreon. Follow me on Instagram, codename Chanel. Also, I have a Snapchat, Chanel Kit Earth. So yeah, go on there if you want to talk to me. I answer my DMs. Like, another little quick little story time. Guys are always messaging me saying, like, are you on blackpeoplemeet.com? Like, they'll ask me these questions and I'm just like, that's not me. And they're like, are you sure? Because, like, why would they say to follow you on Instagram? And I think they want people to see, like, that, or men who they're finessing to see that, you know, I have a finesse channel and it's a possibility that it could be me. But it's not me. I'm really not on any dating sites. Like, I'm not active on any dating sites. So if you see pictures of me, it's not me. I'm not on any dating sites no more. So you're not gonna see me on there. It's a scam, it's not me. And people are taken from people and putting my face in the front. Like,
don't you ever lie on me.
Let me get, if somebody feel like I took from them, like somebody that, you know, like a sugar daddy or somebody in a previous relationship, if they feel like I was in the wrong, then at least I know that I'm the one that benefited from that. So yeah, but guys are always messaging me all the time, like, oh, is this you? And I'm like, no, not me. Mm-mm. Sorry, not I. And it's so crazy because I even took a break from Instagram because people messaging me, is this you on Bumble? You stood me up, we were supposed to have dinner. And I'm like, it was not me, it wasn't me. You think I'm in the shower? It wasn't me. Anyway, y'all, that's it for this story time. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Let me know if that Facebook is still up. Let me know. Go ahead and tell her we know you're a fraud. We know you're not the real Codename Chanel. Oh, also, there's somebody that's pretending to be a me on Twitter, too. I hate it here. Anyway, you guys, I'm out. Thank you guys so much for watching my channel. I appreciate it so much. And I'm out. I'm out.